class 10 students, says, you know, we're in chapter 10, that's commercial arbitrage clause. Okay, so today we shall continue with the same lesson, and the topic is your oil seeds. So India is the leading oil seed producing country in the world. So almost all the types of oil seeds are grown in our country. Okay, it plays an important role in the Indian economy as it is one of the important export item. Most of the oil seeds, okay, they are in great demand in the Western countries. So first let's see groundnut. So groundnut, like India is a leading producer of groundnut in the world. Okay, it's a leguminous crop. It is also grown as a rotation crop. That means it helps in fixing nitrogen in the soil, okay, thereby retaining the fertility of the soil naturally. So, and it grows well in the tropical and the subtropical climate. It requires warm coastal areas with light humidity. Light humidity with the warm in the warm coastal areas are suitable, or these are ideal for the growth of groundnut. And it is also a drought resistant crop. That means it can be grown in the areas where the rainfall is less than 40 cm. But frost is dangerous. Remember, frost is dangerous for the crop. It cannot tolerate even the severe drought also, okay, prolonged and the severe drought, and also the stagnant water. It is harmful for groundnut crop. So now let's see. The first point is it is a kharif crop. That means it's grown in the summer season. Like in southern states and Orisha, it is also raised as a rabi crop. But in the rest of the regions in our country, it is sown or it's grown as a summer crop, that's a kharif crop. So now let us see the climatic conditions. Temperature 20 degrees Celsius to 28 degrees Celsius. And your rainfall is 50 cm to 75 cm. And your soil is dry, light, sandy, loam, or well-drained black soil. Okay. So now let's see the method of cultivation. So it is grown in the rainy season, okay, and it matures within 4 to 5 months only. So the sowing months are June to July. That means the seeds are raised in June to July, and it's harvested in October to December. And during harvesting time, okay, dry weather condition is very much important, or it's very essential during the harvesting season. Now let's see the distribution. So Gujarat is the leading producer of groundnut, followed by Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. So now let's see the second important crop, that means oil seed, it's your mustard. It's an edible oil, okay, like we have two categories, edible, inedible. So edible we have mustard, groundnut, soya bean, and in non or inedible we have castor, linseed, okay. So it is raised as a rabi crop. That means it is sown during the winter season along with the food crop wheat. So therefore its climatic condition is somewhat same, okay, like the climatic requirement of mustard and your wheat is same. So temperature, see the climatic condition, temperature 10 degrees Celsius to 20 degrees Celsius. Rainfall 50 cm to 100, and your soil is alluvial soil. Now method of cultivation, so it is propagated by seed. So sowing is in the month of September to October, harvested in February to March. Then after harvesting, threshing and winnowing are also carried out, okay, to separate grain from the husk. Now let's see the distribution. So Uttar Pradesh is a leading producer of mustard, followed by Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Haryana, Punjab, Assam, West Bengal and Bihar. Now let's see sugarcane. Okay, let's take the last crop, that's sugarcane. So sugarcane is a tall, perennial, tropical and subtropical crop. Okay, and this crop is mostly grown for its juice. So first let's see the geographical requirement. So the temperature 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. Rainfall, it's quite high, it's 100 centimeter to 200 centimeter. Otherwise, if the rain is less, if water facility is less, then it will produce a fibrous crop. But the main intention of grain sugarcane is for its juice. And the soil, alluvial soil and black soil are best suited for the cultivation of sugarcane. But at the same time, it's a soil exhausting crop. So therefore, regular manuring or fertilizers have to be added in order to increase the fertility of the soil. Then number four, dry weather condition during ripening and harvesting. So during ripening and harvesting, there should be no rain. It should be dry condition, dry weather condition during ripening and harvesting. Now let us see the method of cultivation. So it's done in three ways, okay, by seed, set method and ratoon cropping. So the first one by seed, so the seeds are sown between January to April in northern India and between December to January in peninsular India. But this particular method, okay, it is considered outdated, okay, it's less common in our country. So therefore, the farmers, they prefer the other methods, like we have the second method is a set method. So in this method, the cuttings of two or three joints are taken from the top of the heavy cane, okay, and then they have these cuttings are planted at a distance of 1.5 meter to 2 meters. And within 2 weeks, okay, the buds on the nodes, they swell and they burst and the new stalk will emerge from the soil. So that is your second, that's it, method. And the third one is your ratoon cropping. So in this method, sugar cane, okay, the cane is cut close to the ground, leaving a little stalk and the root in the soil. And from the same root, a second crop will come out, okay, the second stem will come, which we call it as a ratoon crop. So the second crop is known as a ratoon crop. So after the first crop, the sugar cane is cut, leaving the root intact in the soil. But the disadvantage is that after each successive ratoon, okay, the crop becomes, or the sucrose contained in the cane decreases. And the advantage is that this ratoon cropping, the advantage of ratoon cropping, it matures early, okay. It is cheap also, and at the same time, it saves time and labor. Now, harvesting. So it is harvested in 10 to 12 months in northern India and 18 to 20 months in southern India. And the harvesting starts before the cane starts flowering. Okay. Then the last point is, canes need to be crushed within 24 hours of harvesting. That means within 24 hours, your cane, okay, it has to be crushed. It has to be taken to the mills. Otherwise, the sucrose content will decrease if it is not crushed within 24 hours of harvesting. Now, let's see the product and the byproduct of sugarcane. So, product, sugar, gur and kamsari. These are the main products. And the byproducts are molasses, bagasse and pressed mud. So, molasses is a dark brown syrup, okay, which is obtained during the refining of raw sugar. And it is used for making alcohol, fertilizers, okay, it's used for making rum. And your bagasse, it's a residue of the crushed cane, that means after extracting the juice, okay, that particular stalk which is obtained, okay, which is left behind is your bagasse. And it is used as a raw material in the paper industry, and it's also used for making cardboard. And the final one is a pressed mud. It is a residue obtained during filtration of sugarcane juice. And this pressed mud, it is used for making shoe polish, wax and a carbon paper. So now let's see the distribution. So Uttar Pradesh is a leading producer, followed by Maharashtra second. Then you have the other states like Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Bihar, Haryana and Punjab. So now let us see the two important topics here. Increased importance of sugarcane in peninsular India. Why sugarcane cultivation, okay, is more favorable in southern states as compared to northern states. So first point, presence of black soil in the Deccan trap, which is suitable for the growth of sugarcane. Second one, maritime climate, oceanic climate, humid climate, which is free from summer dew and winter frost. So this is also very suitable for the growth of sugarcane in southern states. Then third one, use of improved farming techniques, use of modern technique of production. Number four, well planned, scientifically managed plantation. It's well planned and these all plantations are scientifically managed. Then number five, mills are located close to the plantation. That means the sugar plantation and the mills are close by. So the cost of transportation is also less and the sugar cane, okay, after harvesting, they are crushed within 24 hours. Then the last one is the southern states, okay. In southern states, there is a long crushing season. So these are the facilities, okay, enjoyed by the southern states. That means the sugar cultivators in the southern states. Whereas in the northern states, okay, there's a problem. There are certain problems, like problems of sugarcane cultivators in northern India. The first one, use of modern farming techniques or the machinery is not possible because the farmland are small in size. They are small and moreover they are fragmented. So therefore, the use of modern technique of production is not possible. Okay. Then number two, sugar mills are far, so the transportation cost is also more, and moreover, there's a loss of sucrose. Okay. Then the last one, the price is fixed by the government and it does not depend on the quality. So most of the farmers in northern states are not satisfied.